So now I move to the ANOVA. I'm talking about one-way ANOVA, the first case. Even I'm going to demonstrate only the one-way ANOVA only with the use of the Excel. The one-way ANOVA, we need independent variable, dependent variable. And I'm giving the example also. See here, the independent variable, it should be a categorical variable. It should be a categorical, but three classifications should be there. Minimum three classifications. So it means that it greater than or equal to, greater than or equal to three. That it means at least three categorical, like Hindu, Christian, Muslim, or male, female, transgender. Like that, the three classifications should be there in a single independent variable. So in the case, only one variable, one independent variable, so only one IV. That one IV should be a categorical. It's a basic conditions to adopt a one-way ANOVA. In the dependent variable should be a continuous nature. Should be a continuous nature, continuous. Here, the number of dependent variable only one DV. So here DV represent dependent variable. These are the conditions we can adopt a one-way ANOVA. So ANOVA, you already knows that analysis of variance. One way means in the case of one way, how we can decide in the sense based on the number of independent variable. If you are using the number of independent variable only one, you can use the term one way. If you are using the two independent variable, you can call as a two way. If you are using the three independent variable, we may call as a three way ANOVA. So this is where it may be differ. For example, the two way analysis, in the two way ANOVA, we need a two independent variable. Both the variables should be categorical nature. At least one variable should be greater than or equal to three. The dependent variable always in your one dependent variable in all the cases. So the dependent variable only one. There is no confounding variable. There is no confounding variable in the case of. So I am putting it as a no. So there is no confounding variable in the case of the ANOVA. So confounding variable is nothing but the third variable. The third variable effect may influence on the dependent variable. You mean, and I hear the terms intervening variable, moderate variable, mediating variable. That's how I won't focus now, because if I highlight this one, it takes much time. I'm skipping that part, the types of variables and all. The conditions only you have to understand. So if you have the three independent variable, then it's called three-way ANOVA. If you have the four independent variable, then it's called as a four-way ANOVA. So these are the conditions. One independent variable, one dependent variable, continuous nature, it is called one-way ANOVA. Two-way ANOVA, two independent variable, one dependent variable. Three-way ANOVA, three independent variable, one dependent variable. Four-way ANOVA, four independent variable, one dependent variable. You should be understanding the types of the variable also. So in this case, all the independent variable categorical nature, dependent variable should be a continuous nature. When we call as an ANCOVA, analysis of covariance, that also I may highlighting to you. So in the case of the one-way ANOVA, two-way ANOVA, three-way ANOVA, what procedure you are using the independent variable and dependent variable, same things comes here. So in the case of the one-way ANCOVA, ANCOVA means analysis of covariance. Only the difference, one covariance should be there, one covariance. That covariance should be so minimum. I'm talking about minimum one covariance as a CV. I put as a CV one covariance that we may use the term confounding variable. It should be a continuous format. It should be a continuous format. So these are conditions. Kindly check. One way ANCOVA means one independent variable, one dependent variable continuous nature, minimum one confounding variable continuous nature. In the case of two-way ANOVA, I'm already mentioned that based on the number of independent variable only, the one-way, two-way, three-ways to be differ. If you're using the two independent variable, two-way, if you're using three independent variable, three-way, if you're using four independent variables, it's called four-way. So in this case, one dependent variable, the dependent variable always one. But if you have any kind of confounding variable in a continuous format, we may treat it as an ANCOVA. So what is mean by ANCOVA in the sense? The third party variable, the third variable influence, we may nullify with the use of the ANCOVA techniques. So for that, if you want to statistically control the third variable effect, we can depends on that ANCOVA statistics or the partial correlations. There's two statistics we may use for nullifying the third variable effect. just I'm giving the example of one way ANUBHAVA. Suppose you are comparing with religious, so the religious, there is a four classification or three classification: Hindu, Christian, Muslims. Religious with emotional intelligence, or your variable. I don't know about your economics variable. That's why I'm giving a religious with emotional intelligence. In this case, religious is a categorical variable, independent variable. Only one independent variable. The dependent variable is emotional intelligence or social intelligence, social maturity. That particular variable is a continuous nature. So just I'm putting the bracket. It is categorical. It is categorical. Then emotional intelligence is the continuous. So in this case, you can do a one-way ANOVA because one independent variable, one dependent variable. The same thing when you can use a two-way ANOVA. So in this case, religious as well as the gender. So for example, I'm taking as a gender also, religious and gender. We can check that interaction between the religious gender also with the emotional intelligence. In this case, two independent variable and one dependent variable, you can go with a two-way ANOVA. So this is a process. I hope now you understand these differences, these things. These are the basic things. I hope you understand. So I'm skipping and I move to directly to the ANOVA table. Now this is a data sets for you. These are three groups: male, female, and transgender. I already mentioned that. One way ANOVA. When we can use the one way ANOVA, independent variable, dependent variables. In this case, independent variable is a gender. So how many classifications are there? Male, female, and transgender. There is here three classifications of the gender. Therefore, we can go with one way. Why in the one way? In the sense, because only one independent variable in our case. So only one independent variable. So number of independent variable only one. In the case of dependent variable, for example, I am taking this as an achievement score or test score, achievement score. But this variable, it's a continuous format. I already mentioned it's a continuous format. How many dependent variable? One. So these are the basic conditions. We can go for the one way ANOVA, because I'm using one way ANOVA, because we have only one independent variable and one dependent variable, and the independent variable is the continuous nature, so categorical nature. Dependent variable is a continuous nature. Due to that, we are adopting the one way ANOVA. I'm going to tell the path for reaching the one way ANOVA. Go to the data. In the data, go to the data analysis. In the data analysis, you are going to find the options called ANOVA single factor, two factors. So single factor is nothing but the one way ANOVA. The two factor is a two way ANOVA. With the replications, it's called repeated measure ANOVA. Without replications means that's a two way ANOVA. So even there is a repeated measures ANOVA. Like when you go for the first sample, it does know. Two tests, one group, the same mechanisms. If you have the three tests, only one group, you can go with a repeated measures ANOVA and all that. I'm not focusing now because I may focus only the one way ANOVA only in this case. So in this, I'm going to adopt a single factor is nothing but a one way ANOVA. Here the single factor represent based on the independent variable. What is your factor in our case? Our gender is a factor. So see, this is our gender is a factor. Therefore, they're using a set term as a single factor. Now I'm going to do once again, go to the data and data analysis. There I'm going to select the ANOVA single factor. Then after this, click OK. Once I click OK, it asks the input range. For me, the input range is nothing but our variable, the variable of the three groups. So the three groups, male, female, transgender of achievement mark, I'm selecting all together. The input I'm selected. And I'm clicking the labels in the first row because I'm already incorporating the input range, the heading also, male, female, transgender heading also. That's why I'm clicking the label in first row. If you want to change the alpha value, it's called level of significance, 0.01 and 0.05, you can change it. But here I am fixing 0.05 level only. Then click the output range. Then keep the cursor in the part of the output range and select any box here. After selecting, so these are the two things we have to much important. One is input range, second is output range. After selecting the input range and output range, click OK. Then immediately you are getting the ANOVA table. See here, the same thing it comes to the SPS also. Now I'm going to describe the one way ANOVA. The male 15 represent number of male. The 20 count is represent number of female. The 10 is the number of transgenders. So 15, 20, 10. Then this is a sum, is nothing but the total scores of the male, the total scores of the female, then transgender total score. This is for the mean. That is nothing but average. Then you know the variance. The variance is nothing but the square of the standard deviation. That is also there. And this is our ANOVA table. This is the table only you have to incorporate in the dissertation purpose. So this is much important. I hope you're already familiar with these three things. Okay. So I'm just highlight the tables, the table of the ANOVA. These things you must know. Between groups, within group. Normally, the between group we may call as a term SSB, SSW. Okay. So we may use the term SSB represent sum of squares of between groups, sum of square within groups. This is called sum of square total. So normally the SSD total is equal to SSB plus SSW. If you're adding these two terms, for example, if you're adding the 1958 plus 6.64 plus 11,093 plus 0.93 is equal to 13,052. So this is a formula. So SSD is equal to, this is a formula, just I mean, yeah. SSB and SSW, the relationship between the SSB and SSW in the SSD is called the SSB plus SSW. Now the degrees of freedom, I may highlight the degrees of freedom formula. Normally we are using the term DFB, degrees of freedom between groups, is equal to K minus 1. What is K minus 1? Number of groups. So we have the three groups, three category, Hindu, Christians, Muslim. Therefore, what we have to do are, we have the male, female, transgender. Therefore, number of groups is 3. Therefore, 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. That is why you are getting the 2. And DFW, so DF, degrees of freedom within group, is equal to N minus K. So N is equal to number of sample, K is equal to number of groups. So in our case, total number of samples, see here, 10, 30, 45. Our total sample is 45. Our group is 3 groups. What is that? Male, and female, and transgender. Therefore, 45 minus 3 is equal to 42. So you are getting the 42 here. And the formula for the DFT, what is the DFT? Degrees of freedom, the total, the same DFB plus, so we already having the relationship of the SSB with the SSW, with the SST, you know, the same mechanism. The formula for DFT is equal to DFB plus DFW. So what is the DFW? Degrees of freedom between groups, degrees of freedom within group is equal to DFT. That is why you are getting the answer 42 plus 4, 2 is equal to 44. And the general formula for this one is called N minus K, so N minus 1. So there's a general formula for degrees of freedom for the group, N minus K. So our case is 45, 45 minus 1, 44. This also should be the same. And the MSB, so I'm going to highlight what is the MSB. MSB, mean squares of between groups, mean squares of between group MSB, and MSB, mean squares of between group is equal to this divided by this one. So what it means, SSB and divided by, here I'm typing. So MSB is called SSB divided by DFB. So DFB, what is mean? SSB divided by degrees of freedom between groups. We may get the answers. Suppose you want to know how the 979.32, how it get in the sense, just I'm doing the formula, is equal to this divided by, so SSB divided by DFB is equal to, see here, the same answer, 979.32, the same answer we are getting. Similarly, the MSW, so mean square within, what is the formula? SSW divided by DFW. DFW, this is for the degrees of freedom within groups. So the same thing, how this value is coming, the sense is equal to SSW divided by, so I am giving it divided by DFW, DFW, then you are getting the answer 264.14. I hope now we are getting these two answers. Okay. Now, normally we don't need the MST. Now I move to the F value. What is F? The F represents, the F is equal to MSB. MSB, so I'm making it a capital letter. MSB divided by MSW. So mean square between group divided by mean square within group, we may get the F value. So it's nothing but this one divided by this one, you are getting the F value. So this 979.32 divided by 264.14. These two values division is called F value. Just I'm doing the scores now. This divided by this score. So you are getting the 3.70. Yeah. So this is, don't forget this table. And this is logic how the ANOVA table is generated. That's why I'm showing the formula. How the relation between the SSB with the SSW. So if you know the SSB, SSW only, you can go for finding the MSB as well the MSW. So if you are not aware of it, you cannot be understand the scores from here. That's why I'm focusing. The P value is a probability value. In this case, normally we are writing the interpretation based on the P value only. So in this case, our P value is 0.03. So we are going to compare with 0.05 only, because our level of significance 0.05. Therefore, p value 0.03 is less than the level of significance 0.05. It means significant. It is means significant at 0.05 level. So it means what? It means there is a significant influence of the factor of the gender onto the achievement score. Otherwise, there is a significant difference among male, female, and transgender in the achievement scores. Like that, you can write the interpretation. So significant means the null hypothesis rejected. The null hypothesis is rejected. So this is why we have to write the interpretation also. So in this case, based on the p-value, the null hypothesis to be rejected. Therefore, what it means, in the sense, there is a significant difference or there is a significant influence of the gender as a factor into the achievement scores. Like that, you can write the interpretations in it. So I hope now you are understanding the one-way ANOVA.